What's up, guys, and welcome back to the channel. Today we are reacting to the fifth episode of Diary of Our Days at the Breakwater. Oh, I'm so glad to have this back. This one's titled Clamming and an Advisor. Okay, so we're gonna go fishing for clams, as I think that should be fairly obvious. And also fairly obvious, we're gonna finally meet this advisor. She's been in the ED of this show since the beginning. We didn't meet her before the COVID break, and now we're going to be introduced to her. I wonder what type of character she's going to be. Is she going to be a hopeless advisor? Is she going to be a competent advisor? Is she going to be a lazy advisor? There are different ways you can play the advisor type character in that, so I'm going to be curious to see which one they want to go with. So last time, we had a little bit of a shopping trip. Hina got herself a nice new hat after borrowing, it was Yuki's, I think, the last time. And she's like, no, I'm going to get myself my own hat. I'm going to go shop and get my own hat. And also go for like a fishing jacket or something. They call them Jackets, which as far as I can tell is just the German word for jacket. I don't know if that's a particular brand name, a particular style. Like, whenever she was referring to it, it was a very particular design. It looks very much function over fashion, at least. So I don't know if that's just like a brand name, if that's a design style that is well known in Japan. I just thought Yake meant jacket. I did not realize that was going to be something more to it. I was just like, get a jacket. It's like, well, so many different types of jackets. Anyway, after that, we went egging, which is a technique for catching squid. And we caught some squid. It was Ona-senpai that actually caught the squid this time, I believe. So Hina had her catch in episode 3. Ono has had hers in episode 4. I wonder who's going to be getting clams. Maybe because it's clams, it's going to be a little easier. I feel like going for clams is probably easier than squid or what was the other one they were going for? Flatheads, I think it was. So I imagine they're probably easier, so they'll probably all get a clam of some description, maybe. I don't know. I have no idea about how difficult it's going to be or the conditions they're going clamming in. I don't even know how you go clamming, really. I was just like, I know what a clam is. This is about as much as I've got. So, yeah, I guess we'll see how we go about this, but this show's just chill. Like, this is typical Dogakobo, what we all want from this studio, I think, at this point. Like, whenever we see the studio name, we're like, it's gonna be chill. Well, mostly. That's what I expect from them now, and I hope they continue that up, because they do it really, really well. Like, they're one of the best studios at doing this type of show, and I will gladly watch hundreds more of this type of show, easily. So, hopefully, we'll have, like I said in previous seasons, I want there to be a chill show every season. I want there to be a show that we can just sit back, relax, enjoy, learn a little bit, and that's all I want from a show. In winter 2020, we had Asteroid with Love, which was very much similar sort of this. I think it was the same studio, right, Dogakobo? Am I correct in saying that? I think I am. Where is it? Yes, Asteroid and Love, there you go. Singing Yesterday for me was a bit of a different one for them. That was a much more serious one, but still very enjoyable. And they have two shows next season, which are Westgate Park or Ikebukuro Westgate Park. It's a drama mystery romance, so that's going to be somewhat serious, I guess. And then we've got a comedy fantasy slice of life supernatural, which is interesting. About sleeping and demons and stuff, which looks very, very interesting. So they're not going to have a chill show this time. Also, they've got a show scheduled for 2022 already, but none for 2011. Okay. Good to know, Annie-List. Thank you. So yeah, I'm going to get into this episode. I'm not going to wait too much longer because I just want to watch this show. It's just so relaxing and enjoyable. So let's get into this one. As always, these are time-based formats. So in the bottom left of the screen, you're going to see the timer for the reaction. I'll count you down 3, 2, 1, play, and then on play, you hit start, I hit start, we're all going to be in sync. I'll call out the OP and any obvious ad breaks that are in there for those that are watching different versions. I'm watching the Funimation version, since that's what we have here in the West. We have the Kadokawa logo and the Funimation logo at the start of the show. So I'll call those out as well, just so, you know, people who are on alternate versions can actually watch it still. Anyway. I think that's all I had to say. So, yeah, let's get into this week's episode, shall we? In 3, 2, 1, play. Kadokawa and Funimation. Here we go. Again, this music very much reminds me of Eurocamp. Also, who is this? Is this... Oh, it's Yuki, okay. I was about to say it might have been, but... Well, we already know, but I wonder what she's going to think of. There's a sign. Ah, tide coming. Okay. Low tide. Time of year for clams, I'm guessing? I don't know much about fishing still. Yep, washed out. Good. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Gotta love Ono-senpai. Good tip. Hmm. Oh boy. Oh, okay. It very much suits her. This. It's a lot of hassle to get changed. Okay. Interesting. Hmm. Wow. Mm-hmm. Very much so. That face. All right, it'll be time. Okay. I don't think, now I think about it, the advisor's in the ED, but I don't think ever in the OP, because you've got Ono, there's Hina, there's Yuki, and Natsumi. They're all there, but not the advisor. Like, in no shot. Wonder if that's going to change once we introduce her. Just feels odd that they didn't bother to include her. Especially if she's going to be in at least half the show. Well, I don't know how much of a role she's going to play. And we're back. And she's not happy. Alright, low tide, of course. You're going to go around searching for clams, I'm guessing. Mm-hmm. That makes sense. Fair. I mean... Mm-hmm. Yep. Of course, straight to food. I mean, yeah, that's why we do it, isn't it? So. Oh, wow, I was sinking real deep in. Naturally. Just walking away so slowly. Wow. And the chase begins. Let me guess, it's going to get real deep and I'm going to get stuck. To have more people. That's a nice little moment. Are they sinking deeper? It looks like they might be getting a little deeper. No, just stuck. There it is. Oh boy. Let me guess, you're stuck as well. Ah, she's stuck, isn't she? Yep. I mean, it is, but... Ooh, yep, be careful. Wow, really? That's some strength. Oh, damn. Bunch of derps. There's gotta be a technique for getting out of it. No boy. That's just me and Yuki. Wow. I mean, it is a serious point. You need to figure something out. Wow. I didn't think they'd go that way with it, but sure. Oof. And they got out by taking the shoes off, okay. Or the wellies off, I should say. It is. Yep. I bet a lot of people are very thankful for these shots. Ooh. Oh. Some pure luck, really. It's not talent. Excuse me. Yeah. Adorable. All right, back from ad break. Oh, okay. Oh, boy. Oh, they know who it is. Oh, boy. It looks like the advisor is going to be someone a little different. I'm excited. I assume it's the advisor anyway. Oh, yeah, it is. This music, though. School nurse, okay. I recognize your voice. Don't know where from, but I definitely recognize that voice. Yeah, doesn't know anything about the club that she's part of. I get a feeling that's gonna be flipped a bit. Oh. I do wonder. Now you can kill him. Yeah, they are. On the senpai in the background. Yep. Found the weakness. Oh, sorry, on the senpai. Boy. Oh boy. Perhaps she's just a glutton and yeah. Yep. Wow. She's gonna like these two. Okay. Oh boy. Oh boy, what's gonna happen? Don't tell me she's gonna go. Yeah, she was getting liquor. I knew she would be gonna. She's the drunkard. She's the drunkard. Wow. And she leaves. Oh boy. Very much like the advisor from Eurocamp now that I think about it. Yeah. Yeah. I get the feeling something's about to happen. Jesus Christ. Oh, wow. Well, are we a cabaret now? Yeah, you were bullied into it. Yes. She just likes eating. Yep. Beer baka, very much so. Wow. That'll laugh. Yes. Yeah. Also, how's she getting home? Okay. I love her. Okay, that's nice, at least. No. Very much so. God, I'm hungry again. Fair point. Yep. 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 Oh boy. I figured I was gonna be fairly obvious. Yep. Yep. All right. I like her, and she's cuddling the ball. You shouldn't have expected any less, really. That too. Naturally, we didn't just grill them all up. And of course, the big one. Ooh. Okay. God, I'm hungry. Of course, one who found it gets it, so. Yeah, that too, so. Oh no. Yeah. So like, as soon as I saw the I had hyphens after it, I was like, oh no. Oh boy. You are the worst. You are the worst, Sensei. You are the absolute worst. Poor Hina. Oh, poor Hina. Yeah, we need to go climbing again. Oh, haiku for the time. Okay. Good to know. And ED time. Okay, that was a very good introduction to our advisor. Very good introduction. I like her characters. Well, she's horrible, but I love her. Like, you would never have guessed that's her character by this being the only little bits you get to see of her. All right. Next time, we are going here, I guess. Cool. I have no idea what that's going to mean, but we're going there next time. Because we don't get an actual title of the next episode, I don't believe. I don't think anywhere has that yet. I will double check, though, just in case. Diary of Our Days at the Breakwater. Have they put the next episode name out? No, they have not. Okay. Do we even have the advisor listed in the characters? Annie List does not. All right, Mal, here I come. Do you have it? Breakwater. I want to see character list. Nope, it's not listed. I have no idea who this woman is. God damn it. Someone help. Someone help me. Episode 5 discussion. Please, someone tell me who this was. Yeah, Sayaka. Do. Anyone know what her VA is? Doesn't look like anyone's mentioned it. Finally, a single teacher with an obvious reason for being signal. Oof. Okay. Okay. Harsh, but true. So, Sayaka-sensei doesn't look like anyone knows. I guess it's going to be added. Well, whoever's going to... I assume her name's in the credits somewhere of this episode. So, those of you who can read Japanese in the credits, tell me who voices Sayaka, because I would very, very much like to know. Because the voice does... I recognize the voice. Let's just do one last search here. I just want to see if I can find... No, again, it doesn't even list her as a character on Wikipedia at all. Like, it doesn't even list her as a character. Which is odd. Let's see. Anime delayed. Official website. Maybe this will help. I really want to know, okay? Okay, here's the spoiler from the Reddit for the new character being introduced. That's from the manga, not from the show. Let's see if anywhere else has it listed. It doesn't have its own Wikipedia to go with it. Doesn't say. Bunch of new stuff about it. Additional cast. Sayaka Kusani, played by Amy Koshimizu. Okay. Amy Koshimizu. Let's see if I can find what she has been in then, shall we? Let's see. Amy Koshi. Whoops. It helps if I spell her name correctly, doesn't it? Amy Koshimizu. Okay, let's see. Where have I heard her from? Because I've definitely heard her from something, I think. You were in Death Note, apparently. You're in Dog Days. Something that I would immediately recognize. I've got a feeling she might have been in Cells at Work. I have a feeling. You're in Hyoka as Midori. Ah, you're Hollow from Spice and Wolf. Okay, that's something I recognize. You're in Persona 4 as well. Yukiko Amagi. Anything else that's immediately sparked? Like, I recognize you as Hollow. I definitely recognize that. You're in Dust Made of Amnesia as someone. Okay, cool. You're from the Assassin series as Shizuru Miguna. I'll probably find you eventually. You are in My Team Romcom. You're Saki from that show. Okay, cool. Matoi from Kill la Kill, or Ryuko, I should say. I don't know why I say call her Matoi. Ryuko from Kill la Kill. Okay, that's the one I immediately recognize. Oh, you were the... She was the impersonator of Mori Sama from Chunibyo. That's funny. What else? Yeah, definitely recognize you from a lot of things now. You were in Alice and Zoroku, though I don't remember your character. You are in My Hero as the one where, I forget her name, Froppy, whatever her actual name is, goes on there. You're in Overlord as Lacius. Okay. One of the Adamantite Leader of Blue Rose, yes, that's the one. Anything else? Naomi from Darling in the Franxx. Yeah, you've been on a lot of stuff at this point. You're Yamashiro from Azalane. You're in Princess Connect last season. You're going to be playing a character. Oh no, you're the teacher in Misfit, right? Yes, she's the teacher from Demon King Academy also this season. So that's good. Good to know. Yeah, I've definitely recognized your voice from a bunch of things, and now I know exactly what. Good to know. You're also in Demon Slayer at some point. I don't remember. Alright, cool. I'm glad that mystery was solved. So yeah, thank you everyone for watching. I hope you enjoyed that one, because I love this show. It's so chill. It's relaxing. It's funny. We've got another crazy character to join the cast, which is interesting, to say the least. So I'm excited to see her more. I really am, because I quite like her as a terrible teacher and advisor. I still like her a lot. I mean, yeah. So thank you everyone for watching. Leave a like if you enjoyed the episode. As always, it helps boost the channel up. Spread this to more people. Leave a comment what you thought of the episode, as well as anything else that you've been enjoying about this series now that it's back. And don't forget to hit subscribe to see next week's episode, as well as the rest of the summer 2020 lineup you can find on my channel. Little announcement as well, for those of you who have made it this far. I've posted this on my Discord server as well, which you can find in my description. Next week, along with episode 6 of this show coming out, there is the whatchamacallit? There's a 50-minute movie called Hakubo. Hakubo is, I think it means twilight. Am I correct in saying that? I think it was, the English name would be Twilight, which is, fills me with dread and hope at the same time. This was a movie that came out in May 2019, but has now been added to the Crunchyroll lineup. It came out today as I record this, I could have done it ready for today, but I'm not going to. I'm going to save it for next week, where it'll become free to watch for anyone on Crunchyroll. You don't have to be a premium member. So it'll be coming out alongside episode 6 of Breakwater. It's a 50-minute movie, so it's not too long. It's not rated too highly. It doesn't have that many people that have watched it or anything. It's not really that popular at the moment. But obviously Crunchyroll is going to change that, because it's now on Crunchyroll and it will be free at that point. It's also the very first production by Twilight Studio, which is interesting. So I have no idea what their animation is going to be like. But it's a drama romance, and I'm a sucker for romance stories. So, yeah, I'm interested. Original creator, Yutaka Yamamoto, who has created anything that I care for. Or directed anything I care for. I mean, he's directed a lot of stuff. He was a chief episode director, and he did storyboard and script for a bunch of the Haruhi stuff, particularly the first season of those things. He also did the theme song lyrics for Haruhi, apparently. He's done some work on Lucky Star. But yeah, this is an original work, so I'm interested to see where it goes. So that'll be going along next week for episode 6, alongside episode 6, so I hope you look forward to that. So thank you everyone for watching, and until next time, see you guys later.